It is a new day, it's a new month. I'm excited that you're here and hanging out with me and watching. I really appreciate it. If you're enjoying the video, give the video a thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you for all the support of the last video that I just posted. I got a really great response on it. It was a really fun project to work on, so I appreciate it. It was a fun story to tell and really one of the most real and kind of raw videos I've shared at this point about kind of the behind the scenes of Get A-List Fit and why I do what I'm doing with my online personal training. So today we got workout planned, we got some recipes planned, right? And even a little treat to myself at the end of the day. Stay tuned to see what that is. And I think let's get the video started. I'm surprisingly like really awake. I think it's because I did have my first cup of coffee. And I'm gonna do some work on the computer and then I'm gonna check in with you in the kitchen. All right guys, checking in with you here. It is about 11:08 a.m. and I am having my first like full meal of the day. And really it's kind of more of a snack, but I'm trying something new. We're gonna see how this goes. My last recipe did not work well. The last recipe that I put on the blog was a disaster. So this is oatmeal with some Hershey Kisses. We're gonna try to melt this, hopefully that works. So carbs, this is about 2 servings of just like whole grain Quaker oats, like in a huge like Costco size bag, and about 1/2 cup of almond milk, organic unsweetened almond milk. And then I'm gonna show you what I do at the end. I'm gonna defrost some frozen berries, mix that all in here, put a little bit of peanut butter in here as well, and then some agave just to sweeten it up a little bit more. But we'll see how the chocolate chips do, because they might be sweet enough. But excited to try this. Okay, so the oatmeal is all cooked and chocolate kind of melted. I'm gonna let that sit and then kind of stir it around. But I also wanna show you the weird thing I do to defrost my frozen berries. So I just really fill up a glass of water and put hot water in here and it defrosts them. Rather than like having to put them in the microwave and then like melting and getting like mushy, this seems to work pretty well for me. So now I'm gonna drain all of this. I'm also gonna add 1 tablespoon of peanut butter. And then finally a little bit of agave, just for a little extra sweetness. Honestly, it looks pretty hideous, but I don't care. This is like been my go-to treat. It's just like a mess in there. It's so good though. I haven't tried it with the chocolate though. I just got that idea today because we had some old Hershey Kisses left over from a thing we did. Oh, that's really good. Chocolate peanut butter. Berry. It's like a PB&J with Nutella. Anyway, for me, this is a great way to start the morning because a nice carb source really fills me up, it gets me going, gets my metabolism going, and helps me fuel my body throughout the day. So this is something I've been doing really for the last 2 weeks, and it's simple, easy to make, quick to make, which is the most important, and it tastes really good. So try it out, let me know what you think. All right guys, so I wanted to jump into a commentary for this part of the video. This is my chest push workout, so it's really just chest and shoulders and a little bit of triceps. I've been starting all of my chest workouts with this move. I love it because it's kind of an accessory movement. It's not necessarily a big compound movement, but it really warms up your chest and your upper body. So these are the cable flies. I do about 3 to 4 sets of these, starting with lighter weight, working my way to heavier weight. My first set's usually around 15, 20 reps, and then I add a little bit of weight and I do about 10 reps, and then I add a little bit more weight and I do about 8 to 10 more reps. So you get the idea. Now I want to specifically point out form in this commentary. What's really important to understand is, yes, I believe that there is a more correct way to perform an exercise, but also one size does not fit all. So I encourage all my clients to explore and experiment with form. What feels good in my body might not necessarily feel good in your body. So take the time. There's no rush. Find what works best for you. You might find that the incline barbell bench press that I'm doing right here feels better for you when your hands are a little bit further apart versus a little bit closer together, right? Those are kind of the discoveries that I'm talking about. And it's important to acknowledge those and figure out what feels best. So once I finished up with my 5 sets, 5 to 6 reps on the incline barbell bench press, I moved on to the shoulder press here. And I'm kind of experimenting with my form in the middle of this set. I'm doing a fuller range of motion, and then I try to test out a lesser range of motion, and I'm doing about half reps. As you can see, I'm not coming the whole way down for these last few reps because I was feeling it more on my shoulders. I was feeling more tension there, and that's what I was aiming for. And so I said, you know what? In my head, I'm like, why don't I just try a few reps this way? That is the experimenting that I'm talking about. Next, I moved on to these one-arm dumbbell overhead shoulder press. It's good to do some isolation movements, like one arm at a time, just to kind of switch things up. These aren't my favorite. They feel kind of funky, but it is important just to kind of work and isolate one arm at a time. Now it's getting hot, and now I am about to jump into my dumbbell lat raises. And I started with lighter weight, doing about 10 reps. I kept my arms more bent here. Sometimes I keep my arms a little bit more straight. I focus on keeping my pinky pointed out like you're pouring a pitcher of water. But next, I jumped up to heavier weight. So now I'm at 25 pounds, and you can see I'm kind of struggling here. My form is definitely thrown off. I'm kind of just throwing up the weights. And honestly, that's not always a bad thing. Sometimes you need to make those jumps in weight and sacrifice your form a little bit to progress. And as long as you're staying true to the form when you're using lighter weight, it's okay to switch things up and jump up to heavier weight. Just kind of a technique. It's even though it's a sloppy rep, it might be more beneficial for you in the long run, so you can grow and get a little bit stronger. Finishing off these last two moves, that was a overhead tricep extension with a easy bar. And the last move of the workout is this V-bar tricep pushdown. This is heavy weight. My form is not the best. And honestly, that's okay because I wanted to jump up in the heavier weight. Feeling really good about that workout. That is a wrap. Let's get into the rest of the video. What's up, guys? Checking in with you right now because I'm meeting my friend Brian. Haven't seen him in a while. Summer kind of got away from both of us. We were doing a lot of different things. So this will be a great check-in. Really help me, I at least can speak for myself right now. It's definitely gonna help me get focused and a lot more accountable because, you know, meeting with another person, talking about your goals, like I always say, is so valuable. Never underestimate it. All right, I gotta figure out where I'm going. Hold on, 1 second. just a good check-in. I'm definitely feeling a lot more motivated, and also, like, I think the biggest takeaway from that conversation is that you have to acknowledge where you're at and be real with yourself, and, you know, recognize yourself for the little things you did get accomplished. Because sometimes, I mean, it's very easy to focus on what you didn't get accomplished, especially when you're setting big goals, you know, big deadlines. It's all right to admit that maybe you didn't accomplish those big goals, but instead, you know, also recognize for yourself the little things you did get done. All right, now I'm going home, treating myself to a massage. I'm definitely feeling really sore and a little bit beat up and broken, so I think I rarely do this, but only on my birthday. I'm gonna go for it and get a massage. So I'll see you once I wrap up that. I'm like so mellowed out, very zen right now, which is a good thing. But man, I mean, if I could, I would do massages all the time, because it's important to, like, obviously let your body recover, rest, treat yourself. It's relaxing for me. And in the past, I've done some Groupon massages in New York City, which is a little sketch. So this is a good spot. So we're gonna wrap up the vlog. But I'm gonna go ahead and get home first and drink a lot of water because I'm super dehydrated. Hey guys, so I feel like I couldn't finish this video without saying something about what happened in Las Vegas. Obviously what we're doing hasn't been working because events like this keep happening. The idea of community just keeps popping into my head because, like, we are each other's support, and we need to support each other and stop the fighting, and we need to make something change. So I appreciate you supporting me, and I appreciate you watching and hanging out with me. Let's go out, let's be productive in our lives, let's make change in our lives for ourselves and other people. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.